Good afternoon, everybody. Today we are going to discuss our first chapter, that is networking concepts. Imagine life without networking. No phones, no radios, no televisions. It is unbelievable to think life without these amenities. Similarly, a computer network that connects millions of computers together have also become an integral part of our life. For better understanding the networking concepts, we need to know computer network and its components. For that, we have to understand what is a network. When multiple devices are connected together for a purpose of sharing data and information, that is known as network. For example, on social media, you share your information, you create your own network. But the computer networks are different. Now, the question arises that, what is computer network? A computer network can be defined as a group of computers and other peripheral devices that are linked together for a purpose of sharing data and other hardware resources. Now, let us understand it with the help of a picture. In this picture, it is shown that n number of computers are linked together to form a network throughout the globe, and they're connected with each other in such a way that they can share the information and resources with each other very efficiently. For example, if one of the computers in a network has a printer attached to it, then all the computers in that network can access the printer and use it to print the documents as shown in the figure, where computer A and B in a network can give the print command to the printer attached with the computer C. So, we can say that the computers in a network can communicate with each other as well as work independently. Let us discuss with one more example. Here are two computers connected with each other through a medium. They can work independently and also can communicate with each other. Each computer in a network which is connected with each other is called a node. With this picture, it has been clear that number of devices are connected with each other. They are sharing information with each other and known as node. Now, one of these nodes act as a sender because one have to send message and other have to receive. So one act as a sender that transmit the information to the other and known as receiver. For example, one computer is sending messages to the another computer. As I have told you earlier that there is a transmission medium between two computers. Like, these computers are linked with each other through some medium, such as cables, telephone lines, radio waves, or infrared light beams. Now, the question arises that how data can be transferred from one computer to another. Let us understand a computer network as a data communication system with the help of figure. Here, the two computers are linked with each other with the transmission medium, where one computer acts as a sender and another computer acts as a receiver. Now, this data communication system consists of following parts: message, sender, receiver, transmission medium, and protocol. Now, let's discuss this individually. So, first, message. A message is the piece of information to be communicated from one computer to another computer. A message can be in any form, be it a text or picture, audio and video. Second, sender. A sender is a device, that is a computer, a workstation, mobile phone or tablet, that sends the data message through the web browser to any other device. Third, receiver. Receiver is a device that receives the data messages, and it receives the messages from the another device, which can also be a computer, workstation, a tablet, or a mobile phone. Fourth, transmission medium. It is the physical path through which the message travels from the sender to the receiver. Twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optical cable, and radio waves are some of the common examples of transmission medium. So next in the list is protocol. A protocol specifies a set of rules that governs the data communication. Without a protocol, the data cannot be exchanged between two communicating devices. Let's take a glimpse on the advantages of the networking. Networking in the computer brings efficiency, economy, and effectiveness in organization. Wherever we see in every field, you will find a networking is there and they're sharing the information throughout the globe. First advantage is efficient use of storage media. It is more economical to store an application software on a network drive than to store a copy of the application on the each user's storage device. It is better to have one big hard disk in the server than to have smaller hard disk in the different computers. Second advantage, that is preserving information. It is difficult to maintain regular backups on a number of standalone computers. When you keep backups on a central location, you have one place to look for the lost information. That is why preserving is important. The third advantage is reduction in hardware cost. In a network, the hardware devices that are not used, often like modems, printers, scanners, CD writers, etc., can be shared. This reduces the total expenditure on hardware. Network also provide efficiency. In a network, the deletion, modification, or upgradation of the software or data is to be done at a single point only. This brings more efficiency and effectiveness into the working system. Next, redundancy. A network reduces the need for hard copies of all documents. Sharing the soft copies of a file over network eliminates or greatly reduces the need to share the hard copies of reports or any other information with another computer. This reduces a large number of redundancies related issues. Last but not the least advantage of the networking is quickest document delivery. Networking provides a facility to instantly deliver the soft copies from one computer to another computer throughout the world. The next concept in this chapter we're going to discuss is networking media. Now, the data can be transmitted from one location to the another location by using wires or without the use of wires. Firstly, we will discuss about wired networking technology. And in this chapter, we will discuss three wired networking technologies, in which the first is Ethernet cables. Ethernet cables are resembles as a phone cables, and it is larger than the phone cable and has 8 wires. Also, it is connected with various devices such as PC, routers, and switches within a local area network. It has less power consumption. Ethernet cable has also its types, and there are mainly two types of Ethernet cable. First, crossover cable. Crossover cable is basically designed for connecting two computers with a hub or router. Second, straight through cable. This type of a cable has got both its end identical. It uses to connect a computer to a router or a switch. The second in the wired network technology is coaxial cables. So the coaxial cables is used in the transmission of video, communication signals, and audio. It is mainly used by the cable television industry to connect TVs to a cable TV service. A coaxial cable consists of central copper wire surrounded by insulation and then a shield of braided wire. As the Ethernet cables, the coaxial cables also have its two main types, and those are, first, baseband coaxial cables. It supports quick transmission of a single signal at a time, and it is mainly used for LANs. Second, broadband coaxial cable. It transmits multiple signals at the same time and is used for the longer distances, and it looks like this. The third and the most popular wired networking technology is optical fiber. Optical fiber is a popular technology because it has the largest capacity to transfer the data at a very high speed. Fiber optic cable is highly resistant to signal interference and provide better data transmission by providing the high bandwidth. It is also consists of a central glass core containing a bundle of glass threads surrounded by several layers of protective materials. After discussing the wired network technology, now we will discuss about wireless networking technology, which is coming to the picture nowadays. So, the first one is Bluetooth. The Bluetooth is a communication technology that uses the low power radio waves to connect electronic devices wirelessly. It is mainly used with the personal area networks with a maximum transmission range of up to 240 meters depending upon the Bluetooth version. It allows the users to talk and share information like voice, music, and videos. It establishes a short-range communication between phones, computers, and other networking devices. The second wireless networking technology is infrared technology, in which the devices are communicating with each other by radiating the infrared rays. Infrared technology is a short-range communication technology. It covers approximately 5 meters of distance. It is used to exchange the information between computers, cellular telephones, and fax by emitting the infrared waves through infrared LEDs. And remote control is the most common example of infrared communication. The third and the most important wireless network technology which comes into the picture is Wi-Fi. And the Wi-Fi stands for Wireless Fidelity. It creates a wireless local area network that uses radio waves to send the information. Here, the devices requires a wireless adapter connected to them to capture the Wi-Fi signals. Wi-Fi has replaced the wired medium completely and can be used to connect to the internet anywhere, anytime. It is relatively inexpensive and can also be accessed at places where cables are not installed. One can connect multiple devices through Wi-Fi. So, this is all about today's video, where we have covered computer network and its component, networking media and its advantages too. Now, in the next video, we will cover about the network types, networking devices and the protocols. So, till then, take care. Bye-bye.